Hey, and welcome back to the channel. I am Jackie, and today I am hosting my first collab. I've got some awesome other homeschooling parents who are going to be in this collab, so I'm going to drop the playlist below, so be sure to check it out in my description. I hope you guys just decide to watch this whole thing. We are talking about how to make homeschooling affordable. I feel like homeschooling being affordable is so important. So I'm going to share with you some curriculums I found, some resources that I found that are an affordable option for homeschooling, and to show you that you really can homeschool without spending a whole lot of money. So today I'm going to focus on resources that are made for more younger kids, and to show you that homeschooling can be affordable, and there are some really awesome free resources out there and inexpensive resources. On my channel, I have everything homeschool, motherhood, gardening, favorites, essential oils. So be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so that you can get updates for whenever I get new videos posted. Grab a cup of coffee and let's get started. So here's a few free resources that I have found as I am like on my homeschooling journey, and I want to share them with you guys. The first free resource I'm sharing with you today is the Khan Kids app. Khan Kids app is a learning app, and it has so many different parts to it. It has math, it has grammar, it has spelling, it has language arts, it has reading. It has all of these elements to it, and all of it is completely free. So you just simply go to the app store, download the Khan Kids app, and it gives the kids freedom to play. It's a learning app. It has so much on it. We haven't even touched the surface. We only use it every once in a while because we don't use a whole lot of screens as a homeschooling family, but it is a wonderful resource to have whenever we want to use it and whenever I want to supplement with the screen. I always go to the Khan Kids app first. So that is my first free resource. I use it as a supplement, but you could use it however you want. The second free resource is a curriculum from A Year of Playing Skillfully. So A Year of Playing Skillfully, their curriculum actually offers the month of September for a free download. And it's a bunch of different activities that you can implement. You could just spread out those activities and not use them more than once a week. So a lot of really good ideas in that PDF, and you can download that. I'll link that below. So that is the second free resource. The next free resource, which you may have heard about it, is the Good and the Beautiful Language Arts. And they actually offer free PDF downloads. Guys, that is huge. I didn't know about it until about a month ago. And when I found out that it was a free download, I downloaded it immediately, and it looks like a really awesome curriculum. This year we are not using it because I had already purchased or used My Father's World curriculum, but I may look into it in the future. So if you are looking for a language arts curriculum, it is a biblically based curriculum. It is a free PDF download. It even comes with a reader, and it comes with phonics cards. It is like the real deal. So I may end up supplementing with it. That I will link below also. That is a free language arts resource that is a wonderful resource to have. So anyway, I know a lot of people who use The Good and the Beautiful, and they really like it. You might give that a try because you can just download it for free and look through it. Really great resource, free curriculum for language arts. Another free resource that if you are a Charlotte Mason homeschooler, or even if you're more eclectic, is Ambleside Online. Ambleside Online has free lesson plans and free books online. So even if you are not a Charlotte Mason homeschooler, I would suggest checking into it because you may be able to find some books that you didn't want to purchase, and they're right there online. As I have, even just this year, I was looking up poems to read to your first grader, and I was able to download an ebook and just keep it on my computer. So Ambleside Online is a really awesome resource. So I have a few friends who use Ambleside Online pretty much exclusively, and I will link them below so that you can follow along with them and see how they use Ambleside Online, and just get ideas from them. So Ambleside Online is a free resource for homeschooling, specifically Charlotte Mason style homeschooling, but if you're eclectic or just a homeschooler, it's still a really great resource. And of course, the library. The library is wonderful. I talk a lot about going to the library in a lot of my videos because we go to the library a lot. And even with COVID, like, we've been placing holds on all of our books, and our library is offering free curbside pickup. The library is a wonderful, wonderful resource. If you need a book, don't buy it. Go look it up on your library's website and see if they have it first. So that's another great free resource for homeschooling. As for school supplies and looking for free school supplies can add up. And so one place that I was going to recommend was find your local Buy Nothing group. Usually they are Facebook-based group for your neighborhood. If you go to the Buy Nothing Project website, which I will link below, you can look up your zip code and see if you can join a group from there. Basically, you can post on this Facebook group and ask people in your neighborhood, does anyone have an extra set of crayons and pencils for my kids' homeschool this year? I need some extra computer paper. I need some construction paper. Ask the people around you in your community for things that you need. Most of the time, people have extra. Actually, last summer, I was on my Buy Nothing group and a mom posted about a ton of homeschooling resources that she did not need anymore. It was so much, it was like a garage full. And she was like, I'm just gonna schedule a time for you to come to my garage and look at all of these homeschool books. I got so many free curriculums and Usborne books and science curriculums and projects, little project things. It was amazing. You just need to ask around. So a Buy Nothing group is a great place to start if you are trying to keep things affordable while you're homeschooling. Throw out the request on the Buy Nothing group. You never know what people are gonna have. Anyway, that is another free resource for you guys, is hop on a Buy Nothing group. I'll link it below. All right, so I'm moving on now to my inexpensive curriculum and homeschool resources. So my first suggestion is Teachers Pay Teachers. TeachersPayTeachers.com has a lot of PDFs that are very inexpensive, and there may be more expensive PDFs, but a lot of them are very inexpensive to either supplement your child's education or to probably just buy a complete curriculum from it. You would have to look around on it. So that is a good resource if you're looking for inexpensive PDFs. My second suggestion is actually a calendar PDF download from confessionsofahomeschooler.com. It is $3.95, and I actually bought them last year. I bought one for preschool and I bought one for kindergarten, and I probably could have just bought one calendar. So what we did was we used these. It comes with like 100 pages. It comes with the actual calendar portion. It comes with some just activities talking about like, what's the weather like today? What's the time right now? And also you can print out the ABCs. You can print out numbers up to, I think it's 100 with the kindergarten download. You can print out shapes. So it has a lot in it. And we would just, some days, we would do our calendar and I would just supplement a little bit with that, and that would be enough for that day. So having that calendar kind of starts our days now. It's kind of like our morning time routine. We get out the calendars and we look at the calendar, see what the day is, see what our number day of school is, and it's a great resource. It was $3.95. I actually bought two, and I could have bought one and been fine and just printed off what I needed. So you can also save the PDF to your computer, which is the beautiful thing about PDFs, is you don't just download them and leave them on the website, is you can download them and save them so you have them for future use. And so what I did was I did that and I printed off what I needed this year for this school year from that old PDF, and we're just reusing what we have. And all I did was I stuck a little sticker that said first grade over the kindergarten, and I stuck a little sticker that said pre-K over the preschool part. That's what I did. That's one inexpensive way to reuse PDFs that you have. So that's just a little tip, save it to your computer. My third tip for inexpensive curriculum and resources is asking around on different groups that you are in. If you are in homeschooling groups, just ask if someone is selling whatever you're looking for, X, Y, and Z, and see what the price is that they have on it, and see if they'll work with you on the price. Look at half price books, look on eBay, look at thrift stores. I've gotten all of my curriculum online this year. I bought it used. That is a great way to reuse something instead of buying something brand new if it's reusable and it's not a consumable. You also don't pay full price for it. So that's my third tip. I hope that you have found this video helpful on how to make homeschooling affordable. I know that there are so many more resources out there that I don't even know about. Comment below if you're aware of a really great resource. I would love to hear what it is. I just want you to know it is possible to homeschool affordably. You don't have to break the bank to homeschool. Be sure to check out the rest of this playlist to hear more resources on different things and different ways that other moms make things affordable when they're homeschooling. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so that you can get updates for my newest videos coming out. Thank you for watching.